gratifying just to know that you're in this city making a living as a performing artist is something to be proud of.
I agree. It's funny. I was just speaking with a friend of mine who lives in Detroit, and he was telling me what his he's a really, really fine violinist, and he was it just sounded like, you know, everybody he played with, he was playing with these really mediocre groups. And I was thinking, I'm playing with people who play in the Met or the Philharmonic, and they're just the level is so high here, and it's so inspiring, and it fuels me to be a better player and inspires me. So I think I really get to play with the best musicians in the world, and there's so much going on here. So most of the time I'm very busy, which I'm sure if I lived in a different city, I wouldn't be able to say that. And so I'm very grateful to be here by the amazing talent that the city has, and to be able to play so steadily and so constantly all different kinds of music. It's great. It's just a great place to be.
It's affirming to know that your talent and your skill are such that you can make it as a musician in New York.
That's true. That's another way to look at it, because there is so much competition here. So you really have to be quite good to be able to be working all the time. So,
yeah. And it's not for everyone. I think there are people who have the talent, the skill, but New York is not their thing. You know what I mean? So that also is a combination of you have to be somebody who wants to do it here, which not everybody does.
Right.
You have a country house.
I get to get out of here. I don't know. I think if you live in the United States, this is the place to be if you're a classical musician. Mm-hmm. I don't think any place can beat New York. Right?
I feel that way. I love it here. I really feel like I belong here.
Yeah. I don't think I would have these opportunities anywhere else. I came
to New York to be an actor, though, so I didn't even tell people I played piano. It was tucked on the bottom of my my acting resume, special skills. Piano. even though I had been doing it for a living for years, 12 years or something, by the time I moved here, I'd been working for a living as a pianist since high school. I mean, I wasn't making a living in high school, but from college on I was. So I got so tired of playing the same repertoire for college students all the time. I thought playing piano felt sort of dead-endish to me, and it wasn't what I came here to do. I didn't come here to play the same old stuff I've been playing for years. But a year after I moved here, 9/11 happened, and when the job market shifted, Broadway shows closed, many of them, and so the people who were in those jobs as actors moved down a level to off-Broadway and regional work. And then the people who were doing off-Broadway regional work got kind of bumped down. Well, I was so low on the food chain because I was brand new that there wasn't as much work for me. So within about 6 months after 9/11, the acting work kind of dried up for me. And then when piano work started to kind of drift my way, I let it happen. And then as it turned out, I really enjoy playing piano here because I'm not playing the same old stuff all the time. I get to play a lot of new material. And I've discovered something I just never expected to feel, which is that this is where you want to be if you want to do new theater. I could live anywhere in the country and do shows that everybody already knows, that have already been done. But if I want to do a show that has never been done and create something new and interpret it, I should be here, because this is where it comes from. Yeah. I want to orchestrate a Broadway show. My husband and I do this work together, and I've never had a 5-year plan before, but that's my 5-year plan. We're going to have a Broadway show.
I don't know if I have any unfulfilled. I mean, I'm such a freelancer in New York, and most of what I do, I don't have contracts with orchestras or anything. It would be really nice to have a contract with an orchestra. So that would be nice.
Not have to hustle so hard?
Yeah, not have to hustle so hard. Well, I don't think I'm versatile enough, personally. I think nowadays versatility is what it's about. Like my husband, he's unbelievably versatile. But I try to be as much as I can. I do I do Broadway, I do orchestra, I do opera, I do recordings like this project. I've done stuff for film and TV, and I play several different kinds of flutes. But if I could play jazz, that would be another thing that would be really useful, which I don't.
Or like clarinet or saxophone, that would change your...
Yeah, but I've never been interested in doing that. Yeah. So I feel like I want to put my focus, I really want to be specialized in the flute and have that be at a very high standard. And I think it's hard to keep the standard as high as I want it if I start playing completely different instruments. But I mean more like being able to play different genres, like really well, which I... You know, I'm mostly classically and Broadway trained. But I think nowadays, you know, everybody seems really versatile. And they do so many different styles of music. So I wish I were a little more versatile.
I'm thinking about that, the way you responded to, I was never interested in clarinet. The end. To me, that means that you're doing what is true to you.
Right.
And that is, for me, in the big picture, more important than trying to be what somebody would hire. You know what I mean?
Well, I wouldn't mind being able to play jazz, and I don't play jazz, or Latin music or something. I don't play...
Well, there is Latin flute music. There's less jazz flute. There's some, but less, don't you think?
Well, there's jazz. So yeah. There's a fair amount of jazz flute.
I guess I'm not tapped into the jazz flute world.
Yeah, no, there is.
I'm so curious about so many things that versatility is not something I have to work for.
This man is the most versatile man that I know in music.
He does everything.
Yeah, he does everything. And he directs music, orchestrates, arranges, composes, plays piano, sings, and acts. Have I missed anything?
Well, that's a lot. So for me, like, specializing in something is a little harder because I have to, the way my attention span is, it's on or it's shiny objects everywhere. So, for me growing up, I spent a lot of alone time because I would get fixated on something and then go deep into it. But then once I come back out, there's something else and then I want to go deep into that. So I think I have a number of areas I can do with specialty. But there is a trick to building a career. What do people think I am? And it depends in New York on who you ask. There are people who think, oh, he's an actor. And there are other people who think, no, he's a music director. And sometimes they're not even aware that I do the other thing.
Yeah. Orlando has that problem because my husband plays violin and viola.
I could see that easily.
Same thing, has the same problem. They're like, I didn't know you played violin.
Yeah.
I didn't know you played viola.
Which isn't a problem, really, but...
Well, it is in a way because they forget about you for the other stuff.
Because people have sort of a mental Rolodex of, I need a violinist. Well, if they don't even know that Orlando is a violinist, then he doesn't get thought of for a job he might have been just great for.
Yeah.
But that's all right. I would take that. There's always somebody who wants me to do something, so I'm fine.
You do not need to worry about
that. I don't need to worry about that. Shut up. It's the first thing I would say to myself at age 22. Shut your mouth.
I think my career would have been so different if I had gone to school in New York. I got my bachelor's at NYC in Boston, and my flute teacher wanted me to study with somebody there. But I can see now, or if I had moved to New York earlier in my life, I think I would be much more ahead of the game. Because I got to New York in my late 30s, and I was kind of in the same place where the kids that were just graduating from college were. So,
in terms of the kinds of jobs you could get?
Yeah.
Did you find that the experience you had gained elsewhere gave you a depth of...
Oh, definitely. Definitely.
Maturity?
Well, I mean, all the orchestral experience. I had 8 years of full-time orchestral experience, and that was invaluable, definitely. But, yeah, I wish I had stayed in New York. I mean, in high school, I was at Juilliard Pre-College, but then I went to college away from New York. Mm-hmm. So I either should have come back right away, or I should have gone, even better, I should have gone to school in New York. So I feel that was a big mistake. And also, I'll agree, I should have shut up. I just should have relaxed a little bit. I was a little too high strung.
When I was 23, I was playing a lesson for somebody, accompanying a clarinet student. And Bill Dominick, the clarinet teacher at that school, said, "You're a better talker than you are a listener." I was dumbfounded and sort of began to shut up. You can hear more with your mouth closed. You notice more and you hear what people are saying. I wonder sometimes how many things people were saying to me over the years that I just didn't hear. But you have to be ready to hear. You know what I mean? I need to get a bunch of stuff off my chest, maybe, so I'd be ready to listen.
I think I was just too opinionated and, you know, I don't know. I just needed to just chill out a little bit when I was younger. I just remember like getting really involved in the orchestra politics and the orchestra I was in, and you know, trying to change things and everything, and I don't think I really made anything better.
A lot of union things can be like that.
Yeah.
You can drive yourself crazy with the struggle.
Yeah, exactly.
I heard some really great advice from an actor I worked with a few years ago. We were addressing a group of students who came to see our morning matinee. And as always happens, somebody said, "What advice would you give to a young actor?" And this guy said, "Well, I don't really have any training as an actor, except for working," which is kind of great, right? Because this is actually a pretty well-known person. He said, "But you do have to have a life. So if acting is all you're doing, you don't really have anything to act about. What people came to the theater to see is human life. So if you don't have any human life, you don't have anything to offer as an actor." I think that's true as a musician too. To have something going on in your life, you need something going on besides the instrument you play and the notes for living.
What is that
being
for you? What do you have going on besides music?
Well, I'm married. I mean, I wasn't even close to being ready to be married at the time that I heard that advice. Mm-hmm. So something struck home. You know, I thought, well, I could be on this treadmill forever and lonely at age 70, you know, could start letting there be room for something else. Mm. And as you know, this schedule thing is always an issue with me. So I'm still intense with the work, but there's room for other things, though. That's a really good question.
Yeah.
I'm naturally curious, so I'm easily inspired. And I'm not naturally prone to depression or doubt. I mean, I experience it like anybody else, but I think not as often. Because there's always something out there that I haven't seen yet or done yet. Also, we live in a very stimulating place. New York is a bad place to be lonely. It's actually a terrible place to be lonely, because with 8 million people, if you feel lonely, it's like there's really nothing worse. Fortunately, that's not ever my experience of it. I walk outside and everywhere I see things to do. So that's something that I'm grateful is a natural talent for me. I think of that as a talent. Curiosity and being inspired, I think, is something that people have a knack for more than others. If I need to go searching for it, read a poem I've never read before. Go to a museum. Really, anybody else's art, if it's art I don't know already, will fire something up, always.
I'm definitely inspired by a lot of the musicians that I play with that play on a very high level. And I'm also inspired, I love new music. And I love a piece that's exciting, and our trio has a lot of repertoire that fits this. Exciting and challenging. That'll inspire me.
Oddly, shut up is good advice there too. I find if I need inspiration, open my eyes, shut my mouth, open my ears. You know what I mean? Because then something will come in. Yeah, but boo-hoo, shut your mouth if all you have to say is boo-hoo. Because something will come along. Yeah, you just have to let it.